Final year project presentation. My name is Edward Karongo, doing bachelor's in geospatial engineering. My final year project presentation was use of big data analytics technology to create power outage reporting system through Twitter in KPLC. Basically, I'm trying to use big data of real time. We crowdsource from social media and have an insight of it. So what we are doing, my focus is on Kenya Power. Kenya Power, once a customer power goes off in their room, they are supposed to tweet, and we pick the coordinates and geographically visualize it. That is the reporting system. So we will go direct to the system. This is the system. The yellow dots we are seeing, as taught by my professor, is about the power incidences. These are the incidences that have been reported. Now we'll go to the Twitter account. This is a customer called Edward Chexhoven. He has just tweeted 5 minutes ago saying that that hakuna stima in Mombasa. So mine is to mine the data from the social media, be able to automate the process of changing the name Mombasa to pick the coordinates, which is geocoding, then visualize it in a map. So as this is the incidents. We say that it's hash KPLC hakuna stima in Mombasa, by reported by customer Edward Chexhoven. Let us confirm from Twitter. The customer tweeted us 8 minutes ago. So the first thing that we are going to do is that Kenya Power has an administrative department. So the first thing we do is the admin in Kenya Power should assign this case to either the support or the maintenance. The support means this is the customer care in Kenya Power who are normally there to designate different duties to different technicians. The maintenance these are the technicians. The technicians is the person who comes in real time in Mashinani to solve your power outage. So once a case is reported, the first thing that admin will do is to either decide whether it is going to send it to support or maintenance. So here we are going to assign it to the maintenance. We assign the case. Once we assign the case, so the case has been assigned to a certain person in Kenya Power. Once we come to the dashboard, we will see that the status has changed. The status as per now is a bar chart. The bar chart is telling us that one case has been reported. And the case, once we come in the incident map, The incident map is where the power has been reported. We will see that in Mombasa, it has changed the color. Basically, the first time when it was reported, it was pending. So it was an assigned status. Now it has changed status to pending because it has changed colors. And once we come in the task list, now this is the case. This is the case that Edward Chexhoven this is the case that has been reported in the task list. Once we press on the details, we'll see the details. So the case is as we said from Twitter, it was hash KPLC hakuna stima reported by Edward Chex. It was about power outage. The role has been now goes to the maintenance. The maintenance guy is now to pick the case. This is the technician who is going to Mashinani to resolve the case. So he should claim the case. And before he claims the case, let us first confirm in how the incident map. The incident map now is reading this color orange. So once a case is assigned to another department or taken to escalated or done to changing status, it changes the status and also changes the color. So Here we will come. We'll come and in the task list. In the task list, we'll press the task list. We'll see the keys. The guy in maintenance should claim the keys. Claiming the keys means that now he's handling the keys. So once he claims the keys, we'll come to the incident map. Coming on the incident map, we will see that it has changed now the status. Now it is in purple. So what happens now, we should go to the person who has been assigned and carry out another activity which there are like five status. Once we come in the dashboard, now we'll see the case has moved from pending, now it is in progress. We want to demonstrate all these other status, where it's escalated, complete, and failed. So we will go to a case that case has already been claimed. Now the case is in purple. Since it has been claimed, we click into the case and change its status again. We want now to come in the dashboard. We move it to from progress to escalate. Escalate is taking the case to a higher level. So this is what is being done. This is what is being done. We come to the task list. The task list has a case that has been claimed. We have now it's visible that we have two options that we can do to this case. This case, we can escalate it or we can complete it. It means the guy is now solving the case at real-time coordinates. Once we press on escalate the case, we are going to escalate it to someone. There are two users in the maintenance. There is Edward checks, and Mason. So we want to escalate the case to Mason. Mason high is on a higher level. We press escalate. Once we press escalate, the first thing that we should do is come to incident map. See that the case has changed its status, is now in blue. Being in blue, we go to the dashboard. The dashboard, the case has now moved from pending, in progress, to escalated. But we cannot find it in this interface. What we'll have to do, we'll have to log out, then go to Mason. We'll log out, then go to Mason Ridges. The system can always hold one user at one time. Since it has different users, let us log out and go to Mason Ridges. We have escalated the case to Mason Ridges. When we come to the task list, see, we cannot even find the case because now we've taken to Mason Ridges. There are three users, the admin, Chex Howell, and Mason Ridges. So now the case is not even within our side. We've confirmed that it has now, the case changed its status to blue. So the next thing is we should log out in the system, go to Mason Ridges, confirm whether he has received the case. This is another customer from Kisumu who is reporting on power outage. So what we'll do is click at the button, claim the case, and we complete it. Everybody can see it's in the pop-up is in yellow. When you come in the dashboard, you will find that it says one case has been completed. In the incident map, the case that has been completed, it is this one, the green one. The green one has been completed. So the dashboard is showing quite good statistics. So the next time we will pick Kiambu, Kisumu, the case that has been reported, they say that #KPLC #Kisumu. So once it is in #Kisumu, we will assign it to the maintenance team. We assign it to the maintenance team. So once we assign it to the maintenance team, the first thing it should do, it should change the color to purple. Secondly, in the dashboard, we should have a reflection that now there is a pending case. So we come to the incident map. We come to the incident map. When we come to the incident map, we are seeing it as the case has changed. We can click from the incident map, but basically we should go to the task list. In the task list, we are seeing two cases. Let us click at both to see which one is the last. Okay, this one was a formally completed one. So we go back to the task list. We see the other one. This one is a pending status. This is the case that we are trying to work with. We will claim it. Once we it is claimed, we come to the incident map. It has changed the color. This case in Kisumu, it has changed the color to purple. Then in the task list, we will complete it. Once we complete it, once we come in the incident map, it has changed the color. Now it is green. Being green, we head to the dashboard. The dashboard now says that there are two complete cases. It's evidence there are two now complete cases. So that was basically my project. The objectives that I've been working to achieve were first to mine data on power outages. It's everybody is evidence that we went to the social media account here. It was 25 minutes ago as I was editing. We see #KPLC Mombasa, #KPLC Stima. This is the last thing that we've handled. #KPLC no electricity in Kisumu. It was 44 minutes ago. So when I come to speaking that we've mined data on Twitter, it is evidence that it is mining. About big data, this is data of high volume, velocity, and variety. It is evidence that this is data in real-time coordinates. It's streaming data in Facebook, in Twitch. The tweets are streaming, so that is why it qualifies to be big data. Then to automate data cleaning process by geocoding. That by geocoding has been addressed this way. When we come to the last thing like #KPLC, #Mombasa. Mombasa is a name. We geocode, we give it coordinates so that we will be able to map it in the map. So that is to automate data cleaning process by geocoding. To automate process of generating map incidents. By default, everybody can see that a map has been generated. The map that has been generated is through my project. This is a map, and the map, we can remove the layer and we can get back to the layer. How we are doing about the overlay layer one, we are adding a geojson of Kenya. We intersect it with the map. So the other objective was to visualize results of data mined via Twitter on a web application. It is evidence that now this is a web application. We are operating under a local host. So welcome to my YouTube channel, Lifestyle Tutorials. This was my final year project in Bachelor's of Geomatic and Geospatial Engineering. And thank you for being with me.